back to forensic lectures. In this lecture, we are going to see all the hyphenated techniques that are GCMS, LCMS, IRMS and ICMS. So these are all the things that we will cover today. So what are first the hyphenated techniques? So hyphenated techniques is nothing but there is the combination of chromatographic techniques and these spectral methods, okay? Why? Because they both gives the best result when performed together. So they both have, when they are combined, they have the best advantages. So these hyphenated instruments which are there, they are also the combination of acceptance instrumental techniques, like where the sample is passed from the one instrument directly into another. Like hyphenated technique, we combine the chromatograph with the spectral method, right? So this instrument will be connected with the spectral method instruments, okay? And there will be a development of the best state to solve any problem. So let's just first see what is GCMS. So GC, in the last lecture we have seen, right, gas chromatography. So here we are combining it with what? Mass spectroscopy. And the mass spectroscopy we have also learned in the previous video lecture, right? So this gas chromatography mass spectroscopy is the full form of this. So it does what? It studies the both, like all the three types of samples, that is liquid, gaseous and solid. They do what is that? They analyze, okay, bring with the chromatograph where the sample is effectively vaporized into a gas phase and separated into various components using what? Capillary columns. They are coated with stationary liquid phase. This is all like the gas chromatography method, right? So the components are propelled by an inert carrier gas. Carrier gas means what? A gas which carries the particle is known as a carrier gas. So which are they? They are helium, hydrogen, nitrogen, okay? So as a component, they are separated, and each compound elutes means what? Elutes are what? In the last GCMS process we have learned, right? The particle which are moving, the gas particle which are separated from a mixture which has the component, each one particle is known as the elute, right? So this elute, they go from the column at different time based on the boiling point, right, and the polarity. So the time of elution which will be there, it will be known as what? Retention time. So the gas chromatography has the capacity to resolve what? Complex mixture or sample to extract containing hundreds of compounds. Even there are hundreds of compounds in a mixture, then this will do. Then it is connected to the mass spectroscopy and it is detected accordingly. So the principle here is that this GC, it works on the principle like each mixture is separated, right, into individual substances when they are heated, right? So as the substances emerge from the column opening, they flow into the mass spectrometry. So what happens in GC, what was happening, it was going to the detector directly, right, from here. But here we are doing what? We are connecting there a mass spectrometry. So it identifies the compound by mass analyte molecule. So that's how we are combining this both together and getting a result. So next is the LCMS. So LCMS is what? LCMS is nothing but the liquid chromatography combined with the mass spectroscopy. Okay, it uses it involves what? HPLC, high performance liquid chromatography. Yes, this has been also been taught in the last lecture. So wherein the individual components in a mixture are first separated, followed by ionization and then separation of ions on the basis of what? Mass to charge ratio. So it is all separated based on what? Mass to charge ratio. This is important. Then the principle here is that this LC, it separates the sample in components, right? A mixture will be there, it will be separated in component, and this introduces them into the mass spectrometer. Okay, like this LC will be connected to MS. Same way, the MS which will be there, the mass spectrometer, it will detect the charged ion. And this LC-MS it has the particular data, okay, it used to provide information about what molecular weight, the structure, identity and quantity of the specific sample component. So based on all this category, we can define what type of component was present. So then the instrumentation which will be there here, it will be comprised of what LC unit, means the liquid chromatograph. Then the interface between the LC and MS, means the liquid chromatograph will be connected to the MS. Then ion source that ionizes sample, like the API unit. Okay, so the ion guide, the fourth thing will be an electrostatic lens. Okay, it is like a lens which will be electrostatic in nature. It introduces the generated ions into the MS, means some has a connectivity tube like that. Okay, so a mass analyzer will be there that separates the ion based on the mass to charge ratio. Okay, and the detector which will be there, which will detect the separated ions. So they are used specifically in what? In the toxicological division of the forensic science. Okay, so here they analyze the substance for their illicit drug, means what type of drug is there, and to confirm findings of presumptive drug test. So mostly they are used in the drugs toxicological unit. Then next is the IRMS. So what is the full form of this IRMS is that isotope ratio mass spectrometry. Okay, so it is specialization of mass spectroscopy only, because this isotope ratio mass spectrometry, it is a type of that only, in which the mass spectrometric methods are used to measure the relative abundance of the isotopes in a given sample. So here what they are measuring, the abundance of the isotopes. So the technique has two different application in earth science and also in the environmental science. So the principle over here is that the isotope ratio mass spectrometry, okay, it leverages magnetic sector mass spectrometry. So here it is using the magnetic sector, okay, to enable what? Highly precise measurements of the stable isotope content of the sample. So they are measuring this precisable, means in high precision, accurate we can say. Okay, so they are measurement like different types of elements, like specially they are measuring what? Hydrogen, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, and sometimes also the sulfur. Okay, they are measuring accurately, means in how much quantity it is present. Then the parts here of this is that the sample introduction system will be there. Then there will be a electron ionization source which will ionize the electrons. Then the magnetic sector analyzer will be there, means after this how many particles are magnetized. Okay, then a Faraday collector detector array will be there, it will collect all the analyzers. Okay, and a computer control data acquisition system, like a monitor which will be connected to it. And it is used to determine various trace materials, also in the drugs, explosive, food and human remains can also be identified in this. Next, moving on to ICP-MS. So ICP-MS full form stands for inductively coupled plasma mass spectrometry. So it is a type of also a mass spectrometry that uses an inductively coupled plasma, okay, to ionize the sample. So inductively coupled plasma, which will be there when the sample is inserted, it will ionize that sample, and it atomizes the sample and creates a atomic and small polyatomic ions, okay, which are then detected. So it specifically does what? It creates atomic and some polyatomic that are detected. So analytical technique that can be used to measure these elements are in trace level in the biological fluid. Okay, then the principle here is that the high temperature plasma atomizes and ionizes the sample like same way and generating ion, which are then extracted through a interface region. Okay, there will be an interface region which will be there. They are extracted to that and then set into a electrostatic lenses called the ion optics. So ion optics is used here. In the ion optics, it will be there. It will mainly focus and guide the ion beam into the quadruple mass analyzer. Okay, this will be the analyzer. Okay, then next, the detector which will be used here will be IC. Mostly it is short form is known as DDEM detector, okay, or its full form is discrete dynoid electron multiplier. And it uses what the whole thing is used for, like in forensic science also, and also in other field, like the concentration. Okay, we are mainly finding the concentration and great sensitivity. Like this detector, it has a great sensitivity which allows us to determine the concentration up to the ppm or even the ppb. Okay, ppb values. So the sample can be analyzed as solution or solid in both type. Okay, mostly they are used for this in forensic engineering to find the cement, ceramics or glass analyzes due to its capability to analyze both what it is analyzing, measure and the trace elements. Okay, simultaneously both this can be analyzed what? Simultaneously. Okay, which give it good sensitivity. So that's all for today. Thank you. If you like this video lecture, do like and subscribe my channel.